Hey guys, welcome back to the Node.js series, part number 7. Last video we looked at what are the external modules, and this video we're gonna do some coding. We're gonna create our own module on GitHub, and we're gonna consume it in our project. And we're also gonna consume another external module in our project, and we can see the difference. And if you're not following the entire series, please do so. I'll provide a link here in the corner. And welcome to Tixi Tutorials. All right, let's get to the coding. So we're gonna do two things. First, we're gonna create a package that we are going to upload on the GitHub. Now, this will be our external package. And we're gonna create a main project which will consume that external package. And we're gonna also consume a package from one of the package from NPM repo like Lodash. So in our order to create our package, we would have to create a folder. So I'm gonna say makter a useless package, a creative name, and I'm gonna cd into it. And then if I wanna this package to be consumed by other project, it has to have one essential thing, which is package.json. Now I'm not gonna manually create it. There is a command for it, npm init, and that should create it. And it will take me through a bunch of questions. So it's asking me what the package name would be, and I'm just gonna keep it useless package, which is a folder name. And then version, I'm gonna keep 1.0 description. Entry point is I have to have an index.js. A test command, I'm just gonna skip. Author, let's just say Texas. And yes, that's it. So it's created it. So let's look at it. Okay, so I can see the package.json. And as I said, the main is entry point is index.js, so we have to create this file. All right, now let's create some functionality. Useless is .js is one of the files, and let's have some simple functionality. So I can have some const useless equal to, it's an arrow function, which basically says console log, you just wasted some time. All right, and we have to export this. And so as we looked at in a previous tutorial, if I want to export it, I would have to use module.exports equal to useless. So now our module is ready to be consumed. But as I said, in the package.json, we said, oh, our entry point is index.js. So I have to create an index.js. So I'm going to say index.js. And so what this file would consume is, let's say if I have lots of other functionality and I can have a one entry point which imports all those modules and exports it, import it. So I would say useless equal to require, as we know, it's a local module to this. So we're gonna import it and we're gonna export it also, module.exports. Useless. Now, as I said, if you have more than one, then we would create a named export. So we have a bunch of functionality within this. And to upload on GitHub, you have to git init. So it initializes a git. Then I can say git add and git commit dash m. And then I would just say initial commit. And then I have to create this project on the GitHub so I can push it. So what I can do is I can create a new repo and I can create a package. Now already created, so it's not gonna let me do it, but this is how you do it. And click a create repo and it would give you two commands, right? And then you would type those two commands to push your project onto the Git. All right, so now let's create our main project. So for that, I'm also gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna have to create a directory called main proj, and I'm gonna cd into it, and then I have to initialize the project. So I would say npm init, and it's asking me that's the name of it, yes. And it also has an entry point called index.js. And I'm just gonna go through it. Okay, I'm gonna open the project. Okay, so now let's try to consume the package that we just created on my GitHub site. So in order to consume it, All right, so the project is on my GitHub. So the name of the GitHub is called TextEdit. And the project name is a useless package, right? So if I want to install it, I have to do the same thing. So I would say npm install TextEdit slash a useless package. Then I have to give it a branch name. And that happens after the pound sign. Now, initially, whatever you push in, it goes into the master branch. So you have to use master, unless you have created your own branch, then you provide that branch. So it has created this entry inside my package.json called dependency, and it had put that package and its location. And if I look at, it has created a node module folder, and inside I have that package. I have the index.js, and its own package.js, and then the useless. So I would see all the code that is imported to my project. You will also see package.log file. So what is this? Package.log file is pretty important, because what happened is, as I said before, older version of NPM had this issue where every time you do NPM install, it was inconsistent. So now they created this package.log file, which logs whatever you have at the moment. Unless you change something, it doesn't go out and get it. Okay, so it locks the version, and I'm not gonna go too much into it. All right, also let's install a Lodash, okay, which is an external module. So all I have to say, npm install Lodash. And I can provide a version, but I don't really care at the moment. I just wanna get the latest version. But if I wanna install it in the dependency, I can say dash dash save. All right, so now let's try to use both of these external packages that we downloaded into our project. So we need to create a file. I'm gonna call it app.js. Okay, so here we need to first import our useless equal to require, and because it's an external package, it would automatically look through the node module, so it's automatically giving it. I don't have to provide a path. And for Lodash, I would say require. And same thing, Lodash. Now first I'm gonna use that useless. And when I run that function, it should basically print that message that you just wasted some time. So let's do it. I would say node app. And it says you just wasted time on this package. All right. In order to use Lodash, I'm gonna use this. Let's create an array with some values. So I have a bunch of falsy values. Zero is a falsy value, false, and empty string also falsy value. So I can take the Lodash, and I can have a function called compact, which basically removes all the falsy values from my array. So Lodash is a very useful utility, and I can say const new array equal to, and I can console.log the new array. It's compact, not concat. Otherwise it won't do it. So now I run it, it just prints 1 and 2, it removes all the falsy values. All right, so that's about it, folks. In the next video of the series, we're gonna look at a very important module that ships with Node, which is called file system. You can do a lot of file manipulation. So follow the link at the end of this video. And I hope you learned something new from this video. And if you did, please like, subscribe. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and provide a nice comment. And thank you.